What are you ready?
Basically, yeah.
Go on. And they slept and they slide on their body.
Content all by everything.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Today I want to talk about the universe, yeah? Not because I'm wearing NASA, yeah, but it's because I want to talk about the universe, because the universe is the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and in the Quran it says وَلِخَلْقَ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ أَكْبَرْ مِنْ خَلْقِ النَّاسِ. The creation of the heavens is bigger than the creation of people. So if you look at us in the solar system, we're like a tiny dot in the galaxies, and there's billions of galaxies. And when you look at the creation of Allah, you see billions of galaxies, you think to yourself, subhanAllah, like, what a great creator, how great, subhanAllah, like. So you just imagine how small we are in this universe. That just shows you how great Allah is, how many billions and billions and billions of galaxies there are in this universe. So subhanAllah, I want to talk about that. Would you want to say anything about the universe? About anything?
I'll let you start.
What I wanted to say quickly, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم, is that when you think of the creation of Allah, then you will know how great Allah is, and then your iman will become stronger. So when you pray, you'll become more humble in your prayers, because you have Hey, Isa!
I do realize that.
Forget. I don't know what. Yeah, I know what. Do you want to go?
I think we should go in and support him.
What should we go to?
Let's support him. We need something.
What's happening? Why is he getting murked? What are you talking about?
We need someone good at Arabic. Jump on the Arabic thing, right?
Hey, Isa, what's going on?
Let's
go in. Don't make him gash up, man. Make him feel like he needs reinforcement if he's good enough.
Hold on.
What's going on?
No. One second. Can I just say something? Salam alaikum, brother. Verily, I am leaving among you two weighty things. The Thaqalain, the Book of Allah and my progeny. Yeah, this is serious. The Book of Allah and my progeny. If you hold fast to these, you shall never go astray. These two will never separate from each other till they meet me in the front of Kotha. Sahih Muslim. 100 Sahih has said this, bro.
Allahumma
salli ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad wa Ajib wa Rajab wa Al'an Aduhum. No, I backed it.
Wait,
listen.
Go on.
Now, what's the reference for this hadith, yeah? Tirmidhi, and Nisa'i, there's so many references for this hadith, yeah? All from the Sunni books. Tafsir, like, so many, like, go through them. Anyone wants them, I'm here. There's so many to say, yeah, from Sunni books, like 20 references on this hadith. Mm-hmm. But anyway, what I was saying, yeah? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, do not let the fear of people prevent anyone from telling the truth. So obviously, we have to tell the truth, but at the end of the day, we can't just be scared and sit at home or not. The truth is the truth, you understand? Salaam alaikum, say salaam alaikum.
Salam.
Yeah, when he says meet someone, say salam alaikum. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the most stingiest of people who passes by a Muslim and he doesn't say salam alaikum. So when you pass a Muslim, always say salam alaikum, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless you. So for example, when I was talking about the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Imam al-Ruza, the eighth Imam, Isa, come, one sec. Imam al-Ruza, the eighth Imam, what did he say? There's verses in the Quran which are taken literally from other schools of thought. Which, if you, like, obviously, so one of the verses is 83:15. No, surely they will be veiled from their Lord on that day, for example. The Imam replied, Imam al-Ruza alayhi salam, the eighth Imam, the eighth grandson of the Holy Prophet, he said, Allah is not described as having a place for him to be physically veiled from his servants. Rather, this means that they will be veiled from the rewards of their Lord. For example, this is a tafsir. So another man asked about the verse, and your 89:22, and your Lord and the angels have come rank upon rank. Imam al-Ruza alayhi salam, the great Imam, he said, Allah is not described as coming or going, for he is above motion. Rather, this means that the command of your Lord and the angels have come rank upon rank, for example. So the tafsir of the Quran and the tafsir of the ayahs have to be taken from the people who have knowledge. Just like Jesus had knowledge from Allah to bring up the dead, to cure the blind. Solomon had knowledge from Allah. Even the jinn he brought the palace of Sheba with a blink of an eye. It wasn't a jinn, it was the other Sahabi of Suleiman, for example. But the jinn said, I can bring it to you from the time you stand up from your chair. And then the other one said, I'll bring it to you with a blink of an eye. So if you have certain knowledge from Allah, then you can do things. So the Imams, the 12 Imams, they had the knowledge from Allah to interpret the Quran. And the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the Imams after me are 12. First of them is Ali, the fourth of them is Ali, and the eighth of them is Ali, the tenth of them is Ali, and the last of them is the Mahdi, sallallahu alayhi. And then one rabbi came to Imam Ali alayhi salam. He said, oh Amir al-Mu'mineen, how did your Lord come into existence? Imam Ali replied, consider carefully the question when applies to one who did not exist and then came into being. When does not apply to the one who is eternal? He was before the before, without before, and after the after, without an after. He is not the end of some end, so that his end would also end. You understand what I'm trying to say? Listen to that carefully. He then asked Imam Ali, are you a prophet? Imam Ali said, no way, I'm a prophet. I am a slave among the slaves of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Imam Ali was an imam. I'm the slave among the slaves of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So this knowledge, where would you find it from? The Ahlul Bayt, for example, Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq, the sixth imam, the greatest, he was the teacher of all the Sunni schools of thought. When they were asked him about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq, what did he say? No Sunni school can bring you this knowledge. This is the only knowledge can come from the Prophet Muhammad and his family. Every other knowledge is batil compared to this knowledge. So what did the Prophet Imam al-Sadiq said? Whoever may think that Allah is from things or in things or on the things, he has become an atheist. So imagine, whoever thinks that Allah is in something or from something or on something, hello, has become an atheist. And then he asked the Imam, please explain to me. So the Imam said, I intend thereby his being contained, held, or preceded. So I'm going to repeat that to you. Imam Sadiq said, whoever may think that Allah is from things or in the things or on the things, he has become an atheist, shirk. And then Imam explained, I intend by him being contained, held, or preceded. And which is a lot of Muslims are doing shirk. This is the minor shirk, possibly major shirk. In another hadith, it is said, whoever would believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is from things, he has considered him as created. Whoever would think that he is in the things, he has considered him as surrounded. Whoever thinks that he is on the things, he has considered him as being carried. So this all is Imam Sadiq teaching us Tawheed. And Imam Sadiq teaching us what is the true Tawheed. Okay? There's also a verse in the Quran talking to the Christians. What does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say? وَلَا تَجَادِلُوا أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ إِلَّا بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مِنْهُمْ وَقُولُوا آمَنَّا بِالَّذِي أُنزِلَ إِلَيْنَا وَمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ وَإِلَهُنَا وَإِلَهُكُمْ وَاحِدٌ وَنَحْنُ لَهُ مُسْلِمُونَ. So what does Allah say when He says talk to the people of the book? It's very simple. Do not talk to them except for what is best. Talk to them regarding bringing them the best evidences. And then say to them, your Lord and our Lord is one, and to Him we are Muslim. It's very simple. Your Lord and our Lord is one, and we are Muslim. Because everyone has the same Lord, who is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whether you're Christian or non-Muslim, whatever. Our God is one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when we bring all these ahadith from the Ahlul Bayt, what do we want? We want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's message of Islam to be given in the right way, not in the wrong way. Not for any person to come and he gives his opinion on Islam. You understand? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has put people on this earth, the disciples of the Ahlul Bayt, of the Prophet Muhammad, to explain us Islam. The problem with Islam today, why is it so much mess? Why is there so much destruction? Why is there so much ignorance? Why is there so much hate? Why? Because they did not follow the Prophet Muhammad's message. They did not listen to the Prophet Muhammad. What did Imam Ali, Prophet Muhammad say to Imam Ali? He said, oh Ali, know that the most astonishing people to their faith, who have the greatest certainty, the greatest iman, are those who will live during the end of times, who have never seen their Prophet, and the proof is veiled from them, yet they believed as if they have taken brightness covered in complete darkness. So the people in the end of times who believe in the Prophet, these people have the greatest faith. Imagine he's saying they're more than the Sahaba, because they did not see the Prophet and they believed in him. The Sahaba, they saw the Prophet and they believed in him. These people are greater. This is a hadith from the Prophet. It's in the Sunnah and Shia books. They will come at the end of times with the most faith. But they're obviously not better than the top Sahaba, but they're better than most of the people you're calling that saw the Prophet. Because the person that didn't see the Prophet and believed in him has more greater reward than the person that saw the Prophet and believed in him. Do you understand? So at the end of
can you work it over today, fam?
Yeah. So I just wanted to give that knowledge. Big up COE.
Come on.
I know COE, Allah bless him. I just say this all the time. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. Allahumma make the truth victorious, make the believers victorious, and make COE victorious, and come bless COE, make him happy, good wife, good life.
Respect,
bless
up. Thank you. Thank you.
God take over everything. From yeah.
Come, man, say it straight. Man, don't listen to BBC. Man, don't listen to ITV.
Here's the case, right? Here's the case where an African American has been shot, not resisting. Everyone jumps and says, well, look at the general black on black population.
It's terrible, and I don't like racial profiling.
I'm saying why the difference.
I'm going to change it. So there is no racial profiling.
No, but why the difference in treatment?
When everyone's asking, right, for sympathy towards the unarmed killings, right, you say, look at the general population of crime. No worries. But then when you're talking about gaining